Yes, good evening to all. So in this video lecture, I am going to explain about one more type of electric braking called plugging or reverse voltage braking. So in the last video lecture, I have elaborated about the dynamic braking. It is also called as rheostatic braking, which is applied to both the separate excited DC motor as well as DC series motor. Now, if you see, right, in case of plugging or in case of reverse voltage braking, we will remove the supply terminal and we will connect the armature terminal to a reverse voltage, right? So you can see the statement of this reverse voltage braking. In this type of braking, the supply to the armature terminal is reversed and thus forcing the current to flow in opposite direction in the armature circuit. So first we will consider the separate excited DC motor, the plugging of separate excited DC motor. You can see the equivalent circuit of a separate excited DC motor during plugging. Now you can see armature, which consists of terminal A and A, is connected to the VDC through this DPDT switch, and the field is connected to separate DC source. So it is connected to, let us say, V2. So V2 is constant, and if V2 is constant, for a fixed field resistance, the field current will be constant. If field current is constant, field flux is also constant, right? So we are not discussing about the field part because it is providing constant field current due to the constant terminal voltage, constant field voltage. So now to operate this motor in first quadrant, so if you see the torque speed characteristics, so on x-axis you can see the torque, and in on y-axis you can see the speed. So for separately excited DC motor, you will get a constant speed like this, and this is called the drop due to IARA, right? As load increases, the IA will increase, which will increase the IARA drop, and there is a little bit decrement in the speed. So that is why you can say almost constant speed, right? So now now first we will operate the machine as a motor in first quadrant. So to do that, DPDT switch is connected to position number one. So if it is connected to position number one, then this positive terminal of the supply is connected to A, and you can see the direction of current like this from A to AA, and you can see the negative terminal is connected to AA. So you can see the current is from A to AA. So let us say if this is the direction of current, I can see the positive current. Let us assume it is positive current. So now you can see the electrical equivalent circuit when it is connected to position number one, right? So if you see the armature, as I told you in the last slide, that terminal A is connected to battery positive, terminal A is connected to battery negative, and this is the internal electrical equivalent circuit of the armatures, right? So which RA is armature resistance, LA is the armature inductance, and there's a back EMF. This is during running condition. If the motor is rest condition, there is no speed. If there is no speed, there is no back EMF, right? So this is the electrical equivalent circuit. Now you just apply KVL in the loop, because you know the current always leaves from higher potential to lower potential. Now the current always leaves from positive terminal, so it is flowing like this, right, to the armature circuit. Now VD is equal to IARA plus drop across this resistance, drop across this inductance, and plus back EMF. This is the instantaneous voltage, right? Where EG is the instantaneous voltage, IA is the instantaneous current. Now, if you want to write the expression for average voltage, then average voltage across the inductor should goes to zero. Then you can write VD is equal to IARA plus EG. So from this expression, I can write Ia equal to Vdc minus Eg divided by Re. So since Vdc at higher potential, now you can get the Ia as positive. Okay, so what is the torque expression in case of separately excited DC motor? So torque expression is Ka phi into Ia. Since phi is constant because the field winding is connected to separate DC source, K is also constant. And Ia is positive, the polarity of Ia is positive. No? So you will get torque as positive. So now you can see the torque speed characteristics. And since we are applying positive voltage, so we'll get positive speed. So now you can see these are torque speed characteristics of a separately excited DC motor. And somewhere it is operating. So you can see that torque and speed both are positive. And the machine is behaving like a motor and it is operating first quadrant. Now to operate the machine in second quadrant here, right, to move the machine from first quadrant to second quadrant. Now what we need to do, we need to reverse the torque, right? So torque should be negative. So to get this torque negative, so that is depends upon the armature current. I need to change the polarity of direction of this armature current so that I can get torque as negative. So that is done when the DP/DT switch is moved to position number two. So let us see when the DP/DT switch is moved to position number two, what is the equivalent circuit? Now, this is the equivalent circuit when it is moved to position number two, and you can find the external resistance RB in series with the armature, right? So now you can see this part, terminal A is connected to VDC positive through this RB, whereas terminal A is connected to VDC negative. The same you can see from this figure. So here you can see. Okay, so now we need to apply reverse voltage across armature. So previously A is connected to positive, A is connected to negative of the battery. Now we want to connect this A to negative. So to connect A to negative, so what I am doing, I am moving the DP/DT switch to position number two. So now A, it should be connected to negative. So here you can see through DP/DT switch, then it is connected to negative, you can see. And we want to connect B A to positive. So to achieve that one, again, as I told you, DP/DT switch moved to position number two. So you can see it is moved to position number two and through RB, and it is connected to VDC positive. So the same thing you can see here in this figure when it is moved to position number two. It is the electrical equivalent circuit of a separate excited DC motor when it is in position two. Right. So now again, you can see the current, it is getting reversed. Because in the previous case, the current is from A to A. That is what I have mentioned in the last slide. Now see the current. Current is from AA to A, right? That means the armature current is changing its direction. So if that is the case, then obviously the torque will change. So let us apply KVL in this loop. Just apply KVL in this loop. So the applied voltage should be equal to drop across this one, IARB, and drop across the RA, IARA. Drop across the inductor LA dA by dt plus the back EMF, this instantaneous voltage, right? Now, if I want to calculate the average voltage, so then the average voltage across the inductor should go to zero, then VDC equal to capital ERA plus ERB plus EG. So where EG is the average back EMF, right? So from this one, you can see the current, so which is VDC plus EG divided by IARA, and see the direction of current. The direction is opposite to the previous one. So we'll get the current as negative here, right? And the magnitude is decided by this value, right? So now if you see the torque expression, the average torque is given as K phi into IA. So we are not disturbing the field winding. So the field flux is constant. So these two factors are constant. Now, due to this connection, the current IA is reversing, right? So it is having reverse current, so you will get torque as negative. So when you move the DP/DT switch from position number one to position number two, so this is what we have seen when the DP/DT switch is in position number one, right? So now at the moment you move the DPDT switch from position 1 to position 2, then it is shifting to this particular point, right? Now, because our torque is positive, negative, and the speed is positive because it's still connected to a voltage and it is having still the back EMF. So the you will be having certain speed that depends upon the this magnitude of back EMF, right? Thereafter, due to this resistance, so first the field speed fall down to zero some value, right? Thereafter, we will get reverse voltage across because the armature terminals is connected to a reverse voltage. So we'll find reverse voltage across this. So due to this reverse voltage, you will get a reverse speed. And already the current is, there is a change in the direction of the current. So we'll get negative current. So you will get this kind of wave shape when the machine is operating as a braking region, in braking region. So these are torque speed characteristics during plugging. This is one kind of electrical braking, so which is called plugging here. So now that is what about DC series motor. Now we will apply same concept to the DC series motor. Right, now you can see here. So in case of series motor, as you all know that the field winding and the armature, they should come in series, right? So you may have one doubt here that you can connect a field winding here instead of connecting here, right? You can connect a field winding here. So if I connect field winding here, what happens? The armature and the field winding, they are in series, no doubt. So when I reverse the current in the armature as well as the current in the field winding, both are reversing. So which will not reverse the torque. So in the dynamic braking, what we have done, we have to maintain the field current constant in the same direction, we have used a diode bridge there, right? So here also, to maintain the field current in one direction, that is from F to FF, with respect of the armature terminal which is connected to the battery. Now we are connecting this field winding in series with the battery here, right? So even if you interchange the armature terminal, even if you reverse the armature terminal, then the current which is flowing through the field winding is always from F to FF. But you can see it can be A to AA, it can be A to A, that depends upon the armature which is connected to the battery. Right, so let us see. Now I want to operate this machine as a motor, which is in first quadrant. So in first quadrant, the machine behave like a motor. Now to do that one, DPDT switch is connected to position number one. So if I connect it to this DPDT switch to position number one, then you can see the electrical equivalent circuit. So the current always leaves from positive to F, FF. Then you can see this connected to DPDT switch A. So A is connected to positive now. And let us see AA to DPDT, it is connected to negative, right? So if that is the case, so you can see the direction of current will be some A to A, right? So in this direction, the current will flow. Okay. So if that is the case, when the current is flowing from F to FF, and A to AA, right? Then let us assume the currents are positive, right? Let us assume the currents are positive. So now let us see the electrical equivalent circuit. And during this interval, due to positive current and the positive speed, both torque and speed, they are in same direction. So that what we have seen in case of four quadrant operation of this DC motor. So now this is an electrical equivalent circuit when A is connected to positive and AA is connected to negative. And you will be having field winding, right? Internally, you will be having field winding, but I have considered those field winding resistance and field winding inductance here. So because armature and field, they are connected in series. So now this RA1 is the resistance offered by the armature winding, resistance offered by the field winding. It is considering both resistance, like field winding resistance and armature winding resistance. Similarly, LA1 is considers inductance of the armature winding as well as inductance of the field winding. It will consider both, right? So in order to reduce the complexity, I have considered, because they are connected in series, then you can add them, right? So now this is the electrical equivalent circuit when the DPDT switch in position number one. So now you just apply the KVL. If I apply KVL, applied voltage should be equal to drop across this IARA1, drop across the inductance, you can see, and there is a instantaneous back EMF, right? Here you can see RA1 equal to RA plus RSC, series resistance, or because field wind resistance, right? The average terminal voltage you can write by making the voltage across inductor equal zero. So this is VDC, and you can write the expression for the current, right? So from this one, you can say instead of RA1, I can write RA plus RSC or RF, right? So here you can say the current VDC at a higher potential, so you will get the armature current as positive. Okay, so due to this positive current and the positive field current, here you can see when the during this interval, field current is from F to FF, armature current is from A to AA. So we are considered positive. So both armature current as well as field current, both are positive. So now you can get the torque as positive now, right? So if torque is positive, you can say the machine is operating in first quadrant, and you can see the electrical equivalent circuit. Sorry, you can see the torque speed characteristics like this. Now here you can see the torque speed characteristics of a DC series motor. So it is a rectangular hyperbola. Depending upon the load and the speed will vary. Right, so you can see a rectangular hyperbola here, and the machine is behaving like a motor. Okay, now we want to move the machine from first quadrant to second quadrant. So to achieve that one, we need to get a negative torque. So torque can be negative when either if I change the field current direction or if I change the armature current direction. Right, so let us change the field current direction only. Okay, so to armature current direction. So now you can see this is an electrical equivalent circuit when the DPDT switch is in position number two. So now you can see the external resistance here, right, which comes in series with the armature winding, right? So now you can see there is the electrical equivalent circuit, and you apply the KVL, and you can see the current in the field winding, armature winding, is getting reversed. So due to this armature winding reversal current, you will get what is called negative torque. So suddenly it is moving from first quadrant to the second quadrant, and it is following the same torque speed characteristics, right? So at this particular point, the speed will become zero, and thereafter you can see the negative voltage, because still the armature winding is connected to a voltage called VDC, but with reverse polarity, because here I can see the terminal A is connected to negative. Terminal A is connected to negative. That is not the case in case of previous condition, whereas A is connected to positive. So you can get reverse voltage across it. So due to that one, you can see this portion, this reversal portion, right? So this is about plugging of a DC series motor. Now we left with one more concept called regenerative braking. Right, so the conclusion from this plugging and dynamic braking is that due to presence of this external resistance, there is a heat loss, right? And due to this loss, the efficiency of the system is getting reduced, right? So now in order to increase the efficiency, we need to utilize the this heated loss. We need to utilize the loss associated with this resistance, right? So in case of regenerative braking, we are utilizing that heat loss, right? So now you can see in case of regenerative braking, the kinetic energy of the moving system that is wasted in the external resistance in case of dynamic braking and plugging is converted into electrical energy and fed back to the electrical system. So now we are not using any external resistance here, Now, instead of wasting that kinetic energy in that external resistance, now we are utilizing that energy, right? So that is done with the help of this configuration. So first we will consider the separately excited DC motor. Now you can utilize this kinetic energy which is there inside this armature. Okay, so with the help of this configuration, so you can see the power of trans converter. That is the advantage of this power trans converter. So due to presence of this phase control rectifier, fully controlled rectifier, and we can feed this energy, the kinetic energy of the moving system, to back to the source. Right, we will be having some feedback diodes here, and with the help of those feedback diodes, we can utilize them. Right, and there is no external resistance here. Right, you can see there is no external resistance. So we are increasing the efficiency of the system. So let us say the DPDT. Let us say I want to operate the machine as a motor that is in first quadrant. So to operate the machine as a motor, I need to apply some voltage. So the voltage should be positive so that I can get speed is positive, and the current should be positive. So to get positive current, the current should be like this from A to AA. Okay, so to achieve that one, now DPDT switch should be moved to position number one. So if that is the case, what happens? The terminal A is connected to capital A. Small A is connected to capital A, whereas AA is connected to small B. So now you can see the VA here. VA is the average output voltage of a single phase full bridge rectifier. So what is the average output voltage of a single phase full bridge rectifier? It is 2 Vm by pi cos alpha. So where alpha is the firing angle which is given to this converter. So if alpha is less than 90 degrees, I can say VA is positive. We'll get VA, average output voltage, positive. You can substitute any value of alpha, which is from 0 to 90 degrees. And if alpha is greater than 90 degrees, then VA, you will get it as negative, right? So here terminal A can be positive if alpha is less than 90 degrees and B is negative, and terminal A can be negative if alpha is more than 90 degrees, right? So depending upon the firing angle alpha which is given to this controller, you can get the terminal A is maybe positive or it may be negative, right? So let us say during first quadrant, when the machine is working as a motor, alpha is less than 90 degrees. So when alpha is less than 90 degrees, terminal A is positive and it is connected to the machine like this, and you can see the electrical equivalent circuit. Okay, now this electrical equivalent circuit where R is armature resistance, L is armature inductance, E is a back EMF. You just apply KVL and terminal A, which is connected to small A, and now it is positive now. So you can see here positive, right? Terminal A is connected to B, which is negative now. Here also you can see negative, right? You just apply KVL and you can find out the current which is flowing to the armature circuit is this much. So VA is at higher potential, right? So now you can say you will get IA as positive. So if IA is positive, we'll get torque as positive. That means the motor is operating first quadrant. Now let us move on to the position number two. When the DPDT switch is moved to position number two, and if I keep the alpha is more than 90 degrees, then it is a terminal A where you can see negative. It is a terminal B where you can see positive, right? And you can see the electrical equivalent circuit. Okay, you same apply the KVL. You can get this expression and you can find the current as this, right? But you can see here the current is positive. See the current in the armature circuit. So the current always leaves from positive terminal. It is leaving from this positive terminal like this, right? So it is from A to AA, right? So due to this one, you will get torque as negative because the current is getting reversed. So you will get a negative torque. Okay, which means now the machine is operating in second quadrant, that is a braking. Okay, this is about a separately excited DC motor. Now we'll apply the same regenerative concept to the DC series motor. Now this is the electrical equivalent circuit of a DC series motor for regenerative braking. Now in order to maintain the current in the same direction, that is from F to FF, the field winding is used here. So diode bridge is used here. So irrespective of the DP DT position, the current in the field winding is always from F to FF. So because in case of DC series motor, torque is some KB into IF into IE, right? So to get negative torque, either I need to change the direction of the field current or the direction of armature current, but not both. So here we are not changing the direction of field current. It is always from F to FF. So the field current is always positive. But to get the reversal of armature current, this concept you can see the DPDT switch maybe is moved to position number 2 to get the armature current negative. So again, if alpha is less than 90 degrees, right? So this is electrical equivalent circuit where you can see A is positive, B is negative, and D1, D2 will conduct. They will come in series with, and you can get the direction of current like this. So just apply the KVL, this is a KVL expression, where you can say RA1, it is the resistance offered by the armature circuit of the field circuit, field winding. LA1 is the inductance offered by the armature inductance and field inductance. EG is the instantaneous voltage. So you can see here, with RA1 equal to LA1 plus RA plus REC. Right? Similarly, from this expression, you can find out the average output, average voltage. So this is the expression for average, where the average voltage plus inductor will go to 0, and you can see the current. So where you can see the current as positive. So due to this positive field current and positive armature current, you will get torque as positive. That means the machine is behaving like a motor, and which is operating in first quadrant. Now we'll see here. A is positive, B is negative, where alpha is less than 90 degrees. Now if alpha is more than 90 degrees, let us see. When alpha is more than 90 degrees, now A is connected to, you will get negative here and positive here. So which means A will be at negative terminal, B will be at positive terminal, right? And this is the equivalent circuit. Now you can see. So it will be reverse, right? Sorry, the same. Okay, so now you can just apply the KVL and you find out the voltage across the armature circuit, and I can find out the average output voltage. And see, the current in the field winding is from F to FF. But if you see the current in the armature winding, it is getting reversed. So it will be from A to E. Okay, the reverse current is flowing to the armature circuit. Due to this reverse or armature current, you will get torque as negative. So if torque is negative, then you can say that the machine will operate as a generator, and which will operate in second quadrant, right? So with this, I will stop here. So in the next video, we'll solve some certain problems on this electrical braking system. Thank you.